because we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel. Forecast. Weather information you can plan on. Only on the Weather Channel.
5 minutes to get ready to go to the beach, or I'm going without you.
Technology can offer a fantasy future, not somewhere new, but somewhere old. A chance to cling to the past.
Cold front is marked by a blue line with triangular points on it. The front heralds the arrival of colder, drier air. A warm front is depicted by a red line with semicircles. This means warmer or more humid air surges in after the warm front passes. An occluded front is when a cold front overtakes a warm front and is shown as a purple line with both points and semicircles. An L shows the center of low pressure, while an H depicts high pressure. The thin light gray lines surrounding the highs and lows are isobars, or lines of equal barometric pressure. When the lines are very close together, strong winds usually result, as in the case here in the Great Lakes area. Rain is represented by green on the map. The darker the shade, the heavier the rain. Snow is shown as white, while sleet or freezing rain is orange. Last but not least is yellow, which depicts fog. All of these elements come together so the weather can be interpreted easily.
Back then, weathercasters explained the weather by sticking wooden symbols on wooden maps. But in the early 1970s, the technology for explaining weather on TV took a big jump forward to this.
Channel is up.
Really?
Anything this...
This is what it looks like when you're in the Weather Channel studio watching them do the weather.
That's right, Sterling. And this blue wall is called a chroma key wall. It's painted with a special blue paint called chroma key blue. Now, when the Weather Channel is on the air, anything this color is electronically replaced by weather graphics created by a weather computer. Now, this lets us explain the weather using a whole lot of graphics, including video. See?
Okay, so you can replace the blue with anything, right?
That's right.
You can look like I was hanging out on the beach. Or in a hurricane! Ah! Hey, turn up the heat!
Oh, hey, Sterling!
One thing I forgot to tell you, weather people do have to be careful how they dress, because everything that's chroma key blue disappears!
This is your local forecast. Weather information you can plan on, only on the Weather Channel.
Pleasant Thursday morning to you, and thank you so much for joining us on the Weather Channel. I'm Vivian Brown, along with Bruce Edwards, this hour, keeping you updated on the very latest weather conditions across the country. You can see our latest satellite and radar. We wake up to fair skies, a lot of warm air this morning, with temperatures well into the 70s, from Atlanta over to Nashville, Jackson, Mississippi, New Orleans, even some 80s in southern Florida. And readings will be rebounding, certainly, this afternoon, well into the 90s, mid-90s, we're expecting for the Atlanta metro area, so it's really going to be a hot one today. Heat advisories have been issued for many areas. We want you to exercise caution if you have prolonged outdoor activities planned today, meaning if you're planning on playing tennis maybe in the heart of the afternoon, going to play golf or whatever, you definitely want to allow extra time and just slow it down. Don't overexert yourself. You might want to wait until the latter part of the day to get in your tennis matches or your games or whatever, because it's really going to be a hot, sultry one over much of the southeast. Now, yesterday we had most of the severe weather right here across the Great Lakes area. Numerous reports of tornado touchdowns from lower Michigan into Ohio and Indiana. We had reports of injuries, power outages, hail an inch and a quarter in diameter, also winds in excess of some 60 miles an hour. So a very violent weather day yesterday across the eastern Great Lakes. That whole system is moving off toward the east this morning, and we have reports of the rain already in Boston. And this is the region that we will be watching for the threat of more severe weather today, and it includes the big cities over the northeast now: New York City, Hartford, Boston, Philadelphia, D.C. You're even in the threatened area for severe weather as we go through the day today. Of course, we'll keep you posted. So far this morning, you can see the wet weather around Boston. New York City, you're not reporting rain right now, but our surface front is still way back here. And out ahead of it, a very warm and moist air mass. Behind it, it's a little drier and a little cooler. So it's the clash of the air masses at the surface. And also, we have a lot of dry air aloft. And a very strong jet stream here with winds in excess of 100 miles an hour. about 4 miles above the Earth's surface. So all of these ingredients kind of coming together, creating the scenario that will give us the potential for severe weather later on in the Northeast. Again, the same scenario that we were dealing with yesterday in the Eastern Great Lakes. We've had a little piece of that system kind of swinging off toward the south here, and you can see a few storms working their way toward the south now, moving out of West Virginia across the western state, across the western parts of the state of Virginia and North Carolina here, and this all continues to move off toward the southeast. But again, the rest of the southeast, fair conditions this morning. It's warm, it is humid, a muggy start to this Thursday. And here is our next system now. This is a little impulse. A lot of this not touching the ground just yet. It's moisture representative in the mid and upper levels of the atmosphere. But later today, we think all of this will start to sag off toward the south, and we'll be looking for the threat of maybe some storms in parts of Kansas and Oklahoma. The southwest will remain hot, whereas in Phoenix, we're forecasting a high today of about 109 degrees. The Pacific Northwest, you're looking good. Seattle, Portland, partly sunny conditions. Not a bad day at all in the Pacific Northwest. But this is our main system right here. Again, as it swings across the eastern Great Lakes, this is the one that brought the severe weather yesterday, Michigan, Ohio, and Indiana. And again, all of this will move into the northeastern corridor as we go through the day today. So this is definitely our targeted area for severe weather. Look at the current temperatures. Now, this morning, we wake up to readings well into the 70s. So you can see that out ahead of the system, we have a very warm air mass. It's 73 right now in New York, 74 around our nation's capital, 76 Atlanta, 78 already around Montgomery, Alabama. And as mentioned, we have 80s waking up this morning over Florida, Miami, and Tampa, 81, 82 respectively. But cooler air on the backside of that frontal boundary with readings right now in the low 50s, low 60s, Minneapolis, Bismarck, North Dakota, Rapid City, South Dakota, even a 40 here, central Wyoming. And for the West Coast, we generally have 50s in the Pacific Northwest and only cooled to about 86 degrees this morning around Phoenix. So you know, even the deserts of the Southwest, overnight readings are still quite mild. A look at the severe thunderstorm outlook today. Again, right in this area, this includes the big cities now, Philly, Atlantic City, around Baltimore and D.C., Hartford, Worcester, Mass., Boston, Concord, New Hampshire. You're all in the areas now that we're looking for severe weather later today. That means hail, high winds, possibly tornadic activity as our surface cold front continues to punch into that warm and moist air that will build as we go through the afternoon hours. And you remember that other system over the northern Rockies that we said will sag off toward the south and east and bring us the threat of severe weather in Kansas and Oklahoma. Once again, the current scenario looking like this. Let's detail the forecast for you as we zoom into the latter part of the day. Let's show you our water vapor loop first, because I wanted to show you this upper level low kind of spinning north of the border. So even though we do not expect any severe weather today, places like Detroit and back over towards Minneapolis and Chicago, it will be a little cloudy and windy today, but at least no severe weather expected in lower Michigan or Indiana or Ohio like we were dealing with yesterday. But again, still a few low level clouds in the area. Here is later this afternoon, and you can see the front swinging right through central New York State. And then by tomorrow morning now, we think it'll start to edge on off the New England coast, but we have to get through today before we can really say that things look better over New York State, Pennsylvania, and most of the New England coastline. Along this frontal boundary now toward the south, the same system that we're watching today, tomorrow we'll make a little impulse here over central Tennessee, and we might have to deal with a few thunder showers around Nashville and maybe around Birmingham by tomorrow afternoon, of course, the 4th of July, and we'll keep you posted. More details.